I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I am very sinful. Through my thoughts, with my words, what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask this Mary, the Virgin, and all the angels. God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Given us. Authority rests upon archbishop minister, and his name, Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forever. The seal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment where Corypheus was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them at the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and laying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly hosts with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those upon whom his favor rests." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Celebrate Mass on Christmas Day together. The wonder of Christmas and the peace and the joy of the season seem to all shine through, no matter how much our world tries to change it. If we stop for a moment to contemplate the awesome story and the gift that God has given to humanity in Christ Jesus, it's so huge that the human mind and heart can't begin to comprehend. It seems, though, that we as Christians have somewhat given in to social pressure that tries to suppress the Christmas story. Season's greetings feels cold and meaningless. And we wonder how people can be offended with the beautiful message of Christmas, a message that lifts humanity to the level of divine importance. God Himself, the all-powerful, the almighty, creator of the universe, came down from heaven to sacrifice himself out of love for us, to redeem us, to set us free from the chains of sin and death, giving us tremendous hope and life eternal. Jesus tells us that he came so that we may have life and have it more abundantly. How can such a wonderful message be in any way negative? Christ elevates humanity beyond what we could ever imagine. And St. Paul tells us in 1 Corinthians that eye has not seen nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. The question is, how do we love him? Do we love him enough to do his will, to be obedient? Obedient to what he tells us in the Gospels every week. And yes, every week. We can't pretend to know God unless we have a relationship with him and his church, which he established for our sake. To know him is to know the Word, to hear it proclaimed in church where we receive our spiritual nourishment, and to study it. The church is our spiritual mother. It is the body of Christ. We are its members. When we come together, there's a synergy, a wholeness, and power of the Spirit that goes beyond description. I'm sure there are those of us here that feel that today, that sense of unity. Well, Jesus said that Yes, Jesus came to teach us and show us the Father's love, to heal us, to redeem us, but he also came to draw us to himself and to one another. The rest of the world will know that we are Christians by our love for one another. We're all connected. If one of us hurts, we the body hurt. Jesus said in his prayer to the Father, Father, may they be one as we are one, I in them, and you in me. Ultimately, in the end, God will be all in all. God unifies while evil tears apart in order to divide and conquer. But no matter how cruel and dark the world gets, it will never extinguish the hope and the light, which is Jesus Christ. Any effort we make towards moving closer to the light, to God, will bring understanding and consolation, that we may then console others who are suffering with the same consolation that we've received. Well, yes, we're busy. And it seems like Sundays are the only time we have to sleep in. But do we find ourselves wanting or missing something? Are we truly living the abundant life that God intended for us, fulfilling our eternal destiny with hope and faith and love? Or are we just lukewarm? St. Augustine once said that our hearts are restless, O Lord, until they rest in you. Our fulfillment and peace is found in God alone. St. Paul tells us that we should be anxious or worried about nothing, but in all things, through prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let us make our requests known to the Lord, and the peace, yes, the peace that surpasses all understanding, will guard our hearts and minds. This is very encouraging. Prayer moves God, and together we can move mountains. Well, in the Gospel today, Jesus is the good announced by the angel, the Word made flesh, and the light that came into the world to give us light. He also tells us later in Matthew 5:13 that we then are to be the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Christ and Christmas enlightens our spirit. As the members of his body, we've been given a great gift, the gift of Jesus, the Son of God. And in the Mass, when together we receive the Holy Eucharist in communion, we receive none other than the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ himself. The same Christ who on that first Christmas came to us as a child over 2,000 years ago. Well, today, Jesus now comes to be born into the messy stable of our weary hearts, hearts that are open to receive him with innocence and beauty. So let us rejoice with all the heavenly host as we become filled with the hope, the peace, and the joy of Jesus, the Word made flesh, the everlasting light, and the Son of God. May God continue to prosper us all in love together.
True love from true God. God did not make from substantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified on the righteous pile. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again from the third day. In accordance with the scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and through the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess to one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Like the Blessed Virgin Mary, let us bring our prayers to the Lord with complete trust that his promises to us will be fulfilled.
The response to the petition is Christ graciously hear us.
Christ graciously hear us.
For the Holy Church of God throughout the world, that, as she suffered for the nativity of the Lord, she may grow in holiness and fidelity to the gospel, Christ hear us.
Christ graciously hear us.
For all those who do not yet believe in Christ, or who have strayed away from him, that they may know that today a Savior is born in them, Christ
hear us.
For our persecuted brothers and sister Christians, especially in the Middle East, that the Lord will give them comfort, courage, and peace, Christ hear us.
Christ graciously
for peace in the world, that nations, communities, and families may resolve their conflicts by giving themselves over to Christ, Prince of Peace, Christ hear us.
Christ
for those who are alone or abandoned, for the oppressed, the hungry, and the homeless, that the birth of Christ may give them hope, Christ hear us.
Christ
hear
us.
For all the sick of our families and in our parish, that they may join their suffering to the sufferings of Christ for the salvation of the world, Christ hear us.
Christ
hear
us.
For those who have died, especially our loved ones and parishioners who have died of and for the victims of violence, terrorism, and oppression, that by the power of Christ's birth on earth, they may be born anew in the kingdom of heaven. Christ hear us.
Christ
hear
us.
As we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, let us place ourselves under the care of our Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
As the altar is prepared and the gifts are brought forward, let us all join together in singing hymn number 320, Angels We Have Heard on High, number 320.
Thank you. pleasing in your sight, and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you. So that as we recognize in him the God invisible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with the angels and archangels, the thrones and the dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end.
Welcome to the light of your face.
have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver of even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
I too thank His Excellency.